the bluff, where as the sun sets, the jellicle moon rises to illuminate Andrew Lloyd Webber's musical, Cats. Sit back, relax, and let the magic of the evening transport you into the captivating world of the jellicle cats.
Are you say, well, now, how about that?
Do I actually see with my own very eyes a man who's not heard of a Jellicle cat? What's a Jellicle cat? What's a Jellicle cat? What's a Jellicle cat? What's a Jellicle cat?
The naming of cats is a difficult matter. It isn't just one of your holiday games. You may think at first I'm as mad as a hatter when I tell you a cat must have three different names. First of all, there's the name that the family use daily, such as Peter, Augustus, Alonzo, or James, such as Victor or Jonathan, George or Bill Bailey, but all of them sensible, everyday names. There are fancier names, if you think they sound sweeter. Some for the gentlemen, some for the dames, such as Plato, Admetus, Electra, Demeter, but all of them sensible, everyday names. But I tell you, a cat needs a name that's particular, a name that's peculiar and more dignified. Else how can he keep up his tail perpendicular, or spread out his whiskers, or cherish his pride? Of names of this kind, I can give you a quorum, such as Monkestrap, Grasso, or Corico Cat, such as Bomb Ballerina, or else Jellicorum, names that never belong to more than one cat. But above and beyond, there's still one name left over, and that is the name that you never will guess. The name that no human research can discover, but the cat himself knows and will never confess. When you notice a cat in a profound meditation, the reason I tell you is always the same. His mind is engaged in a rapt contemplation of the thought, of the thought, of the thought, of his name, his ineffable.
Jellicle life. For waiting up there is the heavy side lair, full of wonders, angelical, only we'll see. Angelicals ask, because Jellicle's there. Who will it be? Her coat is of the tabby kind, with tiger stripes and leopard spots. All day she sits beneath the stairs, or on the steps, or on the mat. She sits and sits and sits and sits, but that's what makes a comfy cat. That's what makes a Gumby cat.
But when the day's hustle and bustle is done, and the Gumby cat's work has been hard to be done, and when all the families are dead and asleep, she tucks up her skirts to the basement to creep. She is deeply concerned with the ways of the mice,
and their behavior's not good, and their manners not nice.
So when she has got the mind up on the matting, she teaches them
I have a Gumby cat in mind. Her name is
Jenny Annie Dot.
The curtain cord she likes to wind and tie it into center knots.
She sits upon the windowsill or anything that's smooth and flat. She sits and sits
and sits and sits, but that's what makes a Gumby cat.
That's what makes a Gumby cat. But when the day's hustle and bustle is done, and the Gumby cat's work is hard to be done, she thinks that the cockroaches need employment to prevent them from
idle and wanting to swim.
So she slogs on about to have disorderly bouts, a tumor and a discipline.
Thank you. myself. No! Say so catch me in it, but up to my ears, if you put it away, I'm a lot of self.
The rum tum tugger is harmful and knowing. The rum tum tugger
doesn't care for a god or muddle. That's what it is, it's something I enjoy like a horrible muddle.
Thank you.
extensive reputation. We make our home in Victoria Globe. This is merely our centre of operation. For we are incurably given to rope. If the area window is found ajar and the basement looks like a field of war,
if a towel or two comes loose on the roof, which is pleasantly ceased to be waterproof,
if the drawers are pulled out from the bedroom chest and you can't find one of your winter vests, or after supper one of the girls suddenly misses her Woolworth pearls, then the family will say it's that horrible cat. Was it Mungo Jerry
or Rumpel Teaser?
And most of the time they leave it at that. Mungo Jerry and Rumpel Teaser have a wonderful way of working together. Some of the time you would say it was luck,
and some of the time you would say it was weather.
We go through the house like a then the family will say, now which was which cat? It was Mungo Jerry
and Rumpel Teaser.
There's nothing at all to be done about that.
Deuteronomy?
I believe it is old Deuteronomy. Well, of all things, can it be really? Yes, no, oh, my, oh, my eye. My mind may be wandering, but I confess I believe it is old Deuteronomy.
Old Deuteronomy's lived a long time. He's a cat who has lived many lives in succession. He was famous in proverb and famous in rhyme. A long while before Queen Victoria's accession. Old Deuteronomy's buried 9 wives, and more I am tempted to say. 99, and his numerous progeny prospers and thrives, and the village is proud of him in his decline. At the sight of that placid and bland physiognomy, when he sits in the sun on the vicarage wall, the oldest inhabitant crows.
Well, of all things, can it be really? Yes, no, how high, oh, high.
Jellicle leader is here. Jellicle cat can now rejoice.
Jellicle cats, come out tonight. Jellicle cats, come one, come all.
The Jellicle moon is shining bright. Jellicles come to the Jellicle ball.
Jellicle cats are black and white. Jellicle cats are rather small. Jellicle cats are merry
and bright and pleasant to hear when we caterwaul.
Jellicle cats have cheerful faces.
Jellicle cats have bright black eyes.
We like to practice our airs and graces
and wait for the Jellicle moon to rise.
Jellicle cats develop slowly.
Jellicle cats are not too big.
Jellicle cats are roly-poly.
We know how to dance a gavotte and a jig.
Until the Jellicle moon appears.
We make our toilet and take our repose.
Jellicles wash behind their ears.
Jellicles dry between their toes.
Jellicle cats are white and black.
Jellicle cats are a moderate size.
Jellicles jump like a jumping jack.
Jellicle cats have moonlit eyes.
We're quiet enough in the morning hours. We're quiet enough in the afternoon.
Reserving our turfs and Corian power
to dance by the light of the Jellicle moon.
Jellicle cats are black
and white.
Jellicle cats, if we said, are small.
If it happens to be a stormy night,
we'll practice a caper or two in the hall.
If it happens the sun is shining bright,
we would say we had nothing to do at all.
We are resting and saving ourselves to be bright for the Jellicle moon and the Jellicle ball.
Jellicle cats come out tonight. Jellicle cats come one, come all. The Jellicle moon is shining bright. Jellicles come to the Jellicle ball. Jellicle cats tonight. Jellicle cats, come one, come all. The Jellicle moon is shining bright. Jellicles come to the Jellicle wall.
You.
each of us to pronounce that we usually call him just Gus. His coat's very shabby, he's thin as a rake, and he suffers from palsy that makes his paw shake. Yet he was in his youth quite the smartest of cat, but no longer a terror to mice and to rats, for he isn't the in his time. And whenever he joins his friends at the club, which takes place at the back of the neighboring pub, he likes to regale them if someone else pays with anecdotes drawn from his palmiest days. For he once was a star of the highest degree. He has acted with Irving, he's acted with Tree, and he likes to relate his success on the halls where the gallery once gave him 7 cat calls. But his grandest creation, as he loves to tell, was Fire for Fiddle, the fiend.
To know 70 speeches by heart. I'd extemporize back chat. I knew how to gag. I knew how to let the cat out of the bag. I knew how to act with my back and my tail. With an hour's rehearsal, I never could fail. That could soften the hardest of hearts, whether I took the lead or in character parts. I would sit by the bedside of poor little Nell when the curfew had sprung. I swung on the bell. Was when I played this Fire for Fiddle, the fiend of the film. visitory. As fire for fiddle, the fiend of the
Yeah.
crime. McCavity's not there.
From his ears to the tip of his
so clever as magical Mr. Mistopheles.
Announces the cat who can now be reborn and come back to a different Jellicle life.
Yes.